Hi, it's day two of this emotional eating week, and we're looking at different things you can begin to build into your regime to change your relationship with food. And on the task this morning, to ask you to make a list about what you think you were. So if somebody who didn't like you was to stand up and go, here, these are her character, his or her characteristics. I want you to have that list. And I gave an example of my own one. Now I want you to develop that. Whatever your list is, I want you to put it into a pie chart form. And just start segmenting off what you have. So here I've got work. Don't know what that was. And so this can be your relationships. This can be your family life. This could be, for me, research. So just start doing these rounds. So see how these things come. Because at the end of the day, if you've got a nice, balanced vision, it's okay. But as I discussed, there are some people who literally, if they're doing this task, go, well, maybe this is work, and this is all about body image. And if it's like that, you're locking yourself in too much to a particular attitude towards your own body. And this is what Fairbairn describes as one of the major problems of emotional eating. If you make this wrong connection, make this wrong assumption about how you should look in your relationship with food, things go wrong. So the more diverse your life, the more activities you have, the more hobbies you have, the more diverse your work, the more better your relationship with everything becomes. So that's task number eight. B. This is continuing from yesterday. This is Fletcher again, who's got his little sticky fingers all over this, and it's just going to be about, can you change stuff up? Well, what do you habitually do, and can you change those habits? So if you have the TV on all day, especially if you're on lockdown, why not switch it off? If you have the radio on all day, why not switch that off? Are you looking at social media all the time? Why not do that for a day? Now, I'm giving you choices because I know some people actually, you have to have the TV on for work, you have to check social media for work. If that's the case, see if you can choose the radio or something that doesn't affect work, because I still want you to make some money. But emotions, the emotion list, this is totally fascinating. What Julie Simmons says, is that often people just have lost any connectivity with their emotions. Oh, that sounded like a hippie. Yeah, how do you feel about stuff? But everyone jumps to, oh, I think I feel. But there's something, if you remember the old martial arts film, Enter the Dragon, Bruce Lee's there going, you know, don't think, feel. Now, feeling is the way that the subconscious or the primitive part of you communicates with the rest of your body. If you don't pay attention to it, it goes wrong. Now, we're going to use the list, your list and the list I put in the email to begin to make future assessments over the next couple of days. So just do have a little look at the list I put in the email. There's some hierarchical, you know, their big emotions and how they could express themselves. So it makes it super interesting. So, slow release foods. And once again, we're back to the diet aspect of all this. Yesterday we talked about trying to regularize the amount of food you have throughout the day, just drip feeding it in because it controls blood sugar. And inevitably, we've got to have some mention of slow-releasing foods. Yeah, the more refined sugar you take, the more it drives you mad. The more you put, if you like, calming stuff like vegetables, like crusty wholemeal bread that my mother used to lunge at me in the 1970s. It's all for the better because it helps you regulate your blood sugar. All right, so what have we got now? And really what I want you to do now, please do have another practice of that seated contact points exercise. Next couple of sessions, certainly the last two, we're going to be doing some things I'm going to want you to think about stressful events. I need to know you can come out and get back to this place of safety. So it really is really nice if you can do that. Well, look, as with all these things, if you see a task you can't do, don't do it. It's okay. The aim is not to create stress. The aim is just to help you stand outside yourself and look back in at what you're doing. So I hope you're finding it helpful. Day three tasks will be on their way to you later on this evening or early tomorrow morning.